In this video, you'll be learning how to quickly reply from text messages in any app. So for example, if I get a text message, it'll pop up and you'll see I can actually quick reply right there in any app or on the lock screen. So I can just say, hey, and then if I tap send, it'll send a message. Another cool feature about this pop-up is that you can actually pull down your recent conversations and read them so you can, you know what you guys have been saying. So if I pull that back up, and you can actually add more buttons and have multiple buttons down here and scroll through them to do different things like delete the message, mark it as not read and do later, or call the person right there, which is kind of nice. If I hit send, I actually have an opportunity to stop it so I don't, you know, so if you do a misspelling and you want to stop the message, you can actually stop it. And so if I go ahead and send it, it'll send right there and go away, and then you send the message. So this app comes with a companion app, and that's called BiteSMS, and this is a replacement app for your regular texting app. If you want to continue using your regular texting app, that still works just fine, but this is another one that you can use. It's much better, it has much more features. So one thing to note about this application is that you can actually see the pictures right there in the application for your contacts, which is kind of neat. And if you go into the person and you type in a message, you can stop it too. So if you hit stop, it'll stop sending it. So when you misspell it, you can stop and it won't send a message. There's a lot more features than that, and I'll teach you how to set them up in a few minutes during this video. So if you'd like to learn how to install this and customize it and learn more of the features, keep on watching. Hi, this is Luke from GuideMyJailbreak.com, and today I'm gonna be showing you how to install and use an application called BiteSMS. This might be a pretty long app review because it is a very, very fully featured app. So to get started, go ahead and tap Cydia. Tap search and type in BiteSMS. Tap search. And it should be the first one, so you go ahead and tap on it. This is a paid application, but there is a free trial. So go ahead and tap install and confirm. One thing to note is that the free trial does have advertisements. So when you have your trial period, you will have advertisements in the app. You can get rid of those at any time by just buying the app. Go ahead and tap Restart Springboard. That's basically restarting your device, but it's much quicker. After your phone restarts, go ahead and slide to unlock. And you'll automatically see a new app called BiteSMS. It might have a pink icon. I've changed it to the green icon. Okay, so let's get right into the core functionality that everyone's favorite functionality. If somebody texts you, instead of having to go into the SMS app, you'll automatically be able to just tap the reply button and type a reply right there. So this is automatic, you don't have to do anything for this to work, it just works. So there's a bunch of customization you can do, but this is the core functionality that you don't have to do anything to make it work. So you just tap send and it'll send away and you don't have to do anything. So if you go ahead and tap on BiteSMS, you'll probably see a pop-up about a free trial, and you can either continue the free trial or you can purchase it. And you'll see an ad at the bottom, and this is because it's a free trial mode. So basically this app is a replacement of your fully fledged text messaging app. You can do all the same things. You can delete, you can go into a text message, and you can reply, call, FaceTime, add contact, and you can even, you know, send MMSs and everything else. So if you go ahead and click that gear, you'll see a big long list of settings you can change. So one of everyone's favorite is you can hit show contact pics and turn those on in both conversation list and conversation, and then when you go back to your messaging, you'll see pictures of everyone that you text message. So people like that, if you go ahead and go back to that gear and scroll down, if you go to all timestamps, instead of having, you know, a time for whatever time they send the text message every couple hours or however Apple does it, it shows it for every message. So that's kind of helpful. You can turn autocorrect on and off. Another cool feature is that you can delay sending. So say you make mistakes on your iPhone. Everyone does. They make mistakes. They send the wrong message, and it's really annoying. You can actually delay the message for 1 second or 1.5 seconds or however long you want to. So I'll give you an example of what that looks like. So if I go to send a message, let's say I send a message to myself. If you tap send, it'll turn into a stop button, and you can stop it and stop it for it. Send a misspelled word. So let's go back to the gear. You can hide certain contacts. You can turn off the graphical smileys. I don't like having the graphical smileys, so you can turn those off. You can have a passcode for your SMS if you wanted to. You can do a signature. In orientation, you can choose if you want it to rotate or not. Another great feature is retry on failed. So let's say you don't have service because you have AT&T and you want to send a message and it doesn't send, you can actually make it retry automatically. So if I set that to 3, you can see that it'll retry after 1 minute, 2 minutes, and 4 minutes. So that's kind of a nice feature. Quick list and quick compose, I'll go over in a few seconds, but let's go ahead and tap on quick reply. You can choose a bunch of different options to show during a call. So if you don't want it to pop up during a call, you can turn that off. Show MMS means that if you get a picture message, it'll show on the quick reply. And that quick reply is that pop-up that comes up when you're not in the app that you can automatically reply to. You can scroll down and change the text size. And that last thing is configure buttons. So if somebody texts you, you have a bunch of buttons on the bottom and you can scroll through them, which is kind of neat. And you can actually choose what buttons show there. So I don't really like having a pop-up there. I don't really use the templates feature or the Skype feature, FaceTime, forward. You can choose whichever buttons you want on there. You can actually hit the edit button and reorder the buttons as well. And if you tap on lock screen, this is basically whenever your phone is locked on the clock, you can choose some extra options. So you can, for privacy's sake, if you don't want to show their name, you can just turn off the name. And if you want to not show the content, then you'll have to click the show button to show the content. And then you can click reply and you can reply to the message. And then you can also do previous message, and this is a feature I didn't show you, and it won't give you a pull down to see recent messages. So I will turn that on and I'll show you what that looks like. So if you get a text message, you can actually press this little white pull down menu and actually see recent conversation with that person, which is kind of nice. You can either tap it and it'll go away, or you can tap on it and it'll come down, or you can actually just pull it down halfway and scroll through if you want to, just to see the message that they sent you last time. It's kind of helpful. So those buttons I just customized, you can flip through them like this, and whichever buttons you chose to put on there will be there. So if I go ahead and close this message and go back to BiteSMS and tap settings, quick compose is one of my favorite features of this app. If you go ahead and close out of BiteSMS, so if you click the volume button and then tap that pop-up, it'll actually pop up with a message form that you can actually send a message right there in any app, anywhere. So if I type in, you know, myself, and I send a message, I can send a message that quickly, or I can just hit call and it'll call them right there. So if I hit send, then it'll send the message. So if we go to BiteSMS, okay, so let's just finish off this video with a few more features. If you go ahead and click on lock screen mode and then features, there's a couple more features I want to outline. So if you turn pocket protection on, basically it will not allow you to call somebody, so you won't accidentally call somebody or reply to them from your pocket. So I'll show you an example of what that is right now. This is only on the lock screen. So if you turn off your phone to go to the lock screen, you'll see that the call and open button are both grayed out to make sure that you can't accidentally call somebody. I can tap reply right there and actually reply to the message, and then I can call or open the text message right there. So it's kind of a protection against, you know, from you accidentally calling somebody in your pocket if you didn't feel the text message or you can't get to it. It'll protect against that. So if I go ahead and close out of that, and I slide to unlock and go back to the settings. Dim when done, your screen will automatically turn off on the lock screen right when you send them a text message. I really like this feature. If you turn this on, I'll show you another example. So if I turn off my phone again, you'll see that I get another text message. If I tap reply and then I type something, as soon as I click that send button and the delay is done, then it'll automatically turn off the screen. So you don't have to do that yourself. It's kind of a nice feature to make you using your phone a little bit more efficient. So if I turn it back on, so to purchase the application, go ahead and scroll down until you find buy. I've already purchased it, but for you, you're gonna need to purchase it if you wanna get rid of that ad. So scroll down and tap on that $9.99 full license. Type in your phone number, tap confirm, tap next, and then check out with either PayPal or Visa or MasterCard, and that will pay for the application. When that's done, it'll just give you a pop-up saying that you've fully registered it, and you'll be done. So I'm going to go back, and you'll see that there's no ad anymore. So I hope you found this video useful. Check out guidemyjailbreak.com for more videos. Thanks for watching.